astronomical.
This is just magnificent.
Hi, my name's Matt McFadyen. 2 years ago, when I was 23, I decided to attempt to become the youngest Australian to reach the North Pole on foot. And I'm here today to take you all on that journey. But ladies and gentlemen, today there's a much larger team here. I think 1,300 of you to be precise. The devices that you all have that are strapped onto your seat, the little handheld devices, they make you a part of this team. Throughout today, this morning I'm going to ask you to have an input in certain scenarios and questions that will affect the outcome of this trip. It's your voting, it's your input that makes you part of this expedition. Today, ladies and gentlemen, you have the power to get this expedition to the pole, to succeed or to fail. So what type of food would you take on an expedition like this? Pig fat, butter, olive oil. Pig fat, butter, olive oil. But you do get ones that are big, wide expanses of water that you have to paddle. And I can tell you, as you jump onto those sleds that are rafted together, and you slowly make your way across, and you're looking at the Arctic is just black beneath you. You're thinking, oh, I don't want to go in there. Slowly you make your way to the other side, and you send the raft back across, and you ferry the team one by one. And this bear got about 20 metres from me, it stopped. We're screaming at it. Here I am screaming at a 250-kilogram polar bear. Smell us. It stayed with us for about the next 3 hours. As we moved, it moved. One of your team members has the onset of frostbite. Remove the boots, and all 10 toes are grey. Tips are black. What would you do in this situation? Without a doubt, this is probably the biggest decision we had to make. All-time low, you push harder and harder. Conditions start to get worse and worse. These are the moments that you really need to focus on the end result. I woke one morning about 7 a.m. and we were in a complete Arctic whiteout, an absolute horrendous storm. The wind was whistling past over 100 kilometres an hour. The temperature was down at minus 40. I couldn't see 2 feet in front of me. Every single bone in my body wanted me to stay in that tent that day. Stay in the comfort and the safety, but we knew what had to be done. We'd come so far. We knew what had to be done. Today was our day. We were so close to the 18th of April. 2005,
this journey reached its destination. 5, 6, 7, here it is right here.
You've just arrived at the North Pole. Congratulations.
Why we do this. Why we push ourselves to the ends of the earth. It's for that one amazing feeling.